Hi everyone, it's Ruby and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the books I have read in January 2022. So a couple of weeks ago, me and Rayleigh filmed a video for our channel where we showed you guys our book recommendations, and in that video, I got a lot of response from you guys. I got loads of people telling me that you guys had read the books I recommended and that you liked them and you gave me recommendations. I got loads of DMs about books and I was like, okay, we're kind of creating a community here. So I was like, why not create a video for my channel and show you all of the books I recommend? Because since those 2 weeks have gone by, I've read quite more books than I had then. So this video is going to be more of an updated recommendation video, and I'm going to be kind of getting into detail about the books I recommend, getting into detail without spoiling them for you guys. There's actually something that my mum said to me. She said, if anyone had told me that you'd be doing a book recommendation video, then I wouldn't have believed them for a second. And I completely agree with her, because a few months ago I was like completely off books. I hadn't read for a while. I didn't even think about like reading books for a second. It wasn't in my agenda. Then my friend Valera recommended a book to me. I read it and we will tell you that book today, and then it got me into reading. I wouldn't say I'm a bookworm. I just say I like reading. I think it's a good hobby. So for any people who like reading or want to get into reading or want some new recommendations, then this is the video for you, because quite a lot of these books I think are good for kind of young adults. You also might have noticed I'm in a different space today. I'm actually in the studio today. Number one, because it was already set up. Number two, because we were filming something for Ruby and Rayleigh and I thought, why not film it in here, because the setup's cool and it's a different space for my video. It's just a lot like cleaner than my room. My room's cluttered. It's like got a lot of things in there. So now you can just focus on the books for today's video. Also, a quick disclaimer, in this video there will be no spoilers. I will be telling you about the books, and I'll be telling you when you go on Amazon, if you bought a book, I'll be telling you what that says basically. So I'm like a human Google. I won't be spoiling anything about the books. I'll just be telling you kind of the storyline of them and like what I like about them. For the most of these books, they are murder mystery based. I love murder mystery books, just like I love murder mystery films. It all kind of comes into the same peapod. That thing. I'm gonna start with the book which got me into reading, and then we'll just go from there. So the first book I'm gonna be recommending to you all is One of Us is Lying. This book I'm pretty sure is known by a lot of people. It's quite a famous book. A lot of people have heard of it and have liked it. Kind of to tell you what this book is about. It's about five students and they go into detention and then one of them dies. That isn't a spoiler, that's literally at the beginning of the book. It's literally on the back of it. One of them dies, and the whole book is basically about all of these people who are in detention, all of the students being like crime suspects and being interviewed, and they're all like trying to solve the case as well. It's really, really, really good. This is what got me into reading. All I can say about it is that it's a really good murder mystery. I would call it a classic. I literally love all the characters. And they did make a series out of this, like honestly in the nicest way possible. I think it ruins the book. I saw the people and like, it's just, it's a violation. It is very muggy. That is like a statement. But yeah, I wouldn't recommend watching the series. Read the book and then you'll know why. I'm gonna be rating all the books out of five in my opinion. Obviously other people will have different opinions on what these books were like in their opinion. Five being, I loved it, it was my favorite book ever. And one being, I didn't think it was good. One of Us is Lying, 5 out of 5. Definitely my favorite book, I love it. This is the second book, and this is called One of Us is Next. It's the sequel to One of Us is Lying. And this one, again, I really, really liked it. I didn't like it as much as One of Us is Lying because I just didn't think anything could beat it. But it's really similar to One of Us is Lying. It's kind of got the same plot to it, but it's kind of a different situation which they're in. But yeah, I'd give that 4 out of 5, which is still really good, but just when you've read that one, like nothing can top it, if you get what I mean. These two books, 100% recommend. So the next book is The Shadows Between Us. This one, I just need to check something for a second. Yes, okay. So this is basically, the only way I can describe it, I don't want to give anything away, it's a romance book. It's also kind of a murder mystery, but not murder. I really love this book specifically because the female character in it is like one of those like alpha females. She's very powerful, really strong, and I really love that in the book. But it is definitely like a murder, an ongoing murder, but it's also, I really love like the woman in it. She's like, okay, I'll read the back to you because I feel like this will make you. I'm going to woo the king. I suspect it won't be longer than a month before he's helplessly in love with me. And when he proposes, I will say yes. for once the marriage is official, I will kill the Shadow King and take his kingdom for myself. So that was her plan, but you'll see what happens in that. 5 out of 5. I literally love this book just as much as I liked One of Us is Lying. And I did actually mention this in the Ruby and Rayleigh video. I hadn't finished it in that video, but now I finished it. The ending. The ending. By the way, when I'm saying this, I'm going in order of which books I read. So, what did I read next? Next up is a series. This series was amazing. So it is the Selection series. Got a similar sort of plot to The Shadows Between Us, except she's not like a psycho. The girl isn't a psycho. The girl goes over to win the king over, and like all of these girls are lining up to like marry the king. But it's a romance and it's really, really good. So The Selection is the first book, was really, really good. Loved that one. The Elite was the second book. And then the third one is The One. Altogether, I rate this a 5 out of 5. I love this. The whole Selection series is just so good. There's a lot of twists. 100% recommend. Yeah, when you read a series of books, when you've read the first one, you go on to the second one straight away. And then before you know it, you finished it. And that's how it went with me. And I was really sad I finished it. There's actually, I think there's like a couple more books to this series, but it's not with these characters. It's to the daughter's perspective. So I'm not gonna read that at the moment. I might, but apparently it's just not as good. And I don't wanna ruin the books for me. Yeah, really good series. The next book, I think it's actually a really well-known book. I'm pretty sure it's a famous book because apparently it came out and everyone loved it, which I support 100%. Definitely not overhyped, let's just say that. This one is called The Inheritance Games. It is a murder mystery, and this is like a full-on murder mystery book. It's about this girl called Avery, and a billionaire dies. She gets all his money, all of his belongings, and all the family is like, why did she just get all my money? I'm gonna figure out why. And all like the brothers and her figure out why, and there's so many twists in this book, so many twists, and it's so good. It's really, really, really good. This is probably, actually it probably tops One of Us Lying. I absolutely love this book. This is a 3-book series. The second book to this is The Hawthorne Legacy, and it's not anything different. It's just like the second book to this. It just carries it on, which definitely it needs carrying on because there's a massive cliffhanger at the end. These two are amazing books, and there actually is a third one coming out. So I have to wait till I think it's August 2022 to get the third book. So good. Let's just say like all of these are 5s and this just is like a 10. Next book is the Divergent book. This is a book to a 3-book series. This is also a film. I think it was made into a film after the book. I'm not really sure. Correct me if I'm wrong. This was a really good book. It's a dystopian book, I'd say. I really like this book. The thing about it is I'd already watched the movies, so I knew the whole plot. I knew what was going to happen in the book. I think it kind of ruined the book for me, so I know that if I hadn't watched the movies, I would have loved it. But I liked this book. I didn't love it, because I already knew what was happening. If I hadn't have watched the films, I know I would have loved it. This is definitely a 4 out of 5. If you haven't watched the film or read it, then read the book first. Really good book, recommend. This is the second to last book. This one, I have quite a lot to say about it. So this is called Legend. I'm pretty sure there's a second book to it. I think it's called Prodigy. This one's basically about a boy who has like committed loads of crimes. There's a big twist in this book, which you will see. I wouldn't say I recommend this book as much as them. It was slow, really slow. And then at the end it got like good, but not that good. I feel like it is a good like dystopian book, but I just didn't enjoy it as much as my other books I have. If you want to read it, try it out, tell me what you think. Everyone has different opinions. I think I'll give this one like a 3. Finally, the last book. This one is called The Daughter of the Pirate King. Now, I literally just got this book today. I wanted to get it when I was in Waterstones. I didn't find it, so I ordered it online. This girl, apparently she's like an alpha female role as well. She's set on a mission to find treasure, I think. I think it's a romance, I think. She's the daughter of Jack Sparrow or something. I don't really know anything about this book. All I know is that it's known to be really good. Apparently it's quite similar to The Shadows Between Us. It's also got the same author as The Shadows Between Us, which might be why they're so similar. I can tell I'm gonna like this book and I'm very excited to read it. Definitely recommend it already. They're all the books I've read in January. There's a lot of them. I mean, I wouldn't say like I read all the time. When I started reading, I read all the time. Then I kind of stopped reading a little bit. I got back into school and I kind of stopped reading as much. But I do like read quite a lot in a week. Yeah, it's really calming. Like, I really love reading and then putting a candle on. Definitely, if you're trying to get into reading and you don't know what genre to get, murder mystery is really, really good. I like some dystopian books are good, but they can sometimes be disappointing or like a bit cringy. Romance are good, except I don't like love romance. I more prefer murder mystery than romance book. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to comment any book recommendations you have for me. I'm kind of lost. I don't really know what other books to read. And if you kind of got a gist of the sort of books I like in this video, then make sure to comment down below. So thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you all next week. Bye.
Enchantée.